Good morning. So today is part two of my trip around Victoria. And this time I'm exploring around the southeastern areas of the state. So when I was on the plane flying out here to Australia, starting a new life and all that, I looked out the window and saw a town. I looked at the map and we were flying above Traralgon. Sounds a bit like a Middle Earth sort of place, but they call it Traralgon or something here. So, well, anyway, I was heading out here to Traralgon. I'm still not there yet. I'm at a place which I think is called Trafalgar, and there was a sign saying that there was a Holden Museum. So just like yesterday, I had to pull over and take a look.
In this dirty old part of the city, where the sun refused to shine, people tell me there ain't no use in trying. Now my girl, you're so young and pretty, and one thing I know is true, you'll be dead before your time is due.
So today I had a look at the museum, and yeah, it's pretty good. It's a lot like the one in Echuca, a lot of old FJ up to WB Holdens. There's probably more here actually, and yeah, it's quite interesting. I'll just flip the camera around while I show you the outside. So it says Holden up there, Shannon's over there. There's a few Holdens out there that worker seems to be the owner of a Monaro. I couldn't see the front, but it's an H body, probably HK before HQ. Right, so I've been in this Hyundai i30 for a day and a half now, and a really quick review. I hate this headrest. It's so bad. It's pushing my head forwards and making my body into a C shape. Not much I can say. Everything is quite new, so it's a different experience from what I'm used to. So yeah, I'm still not used to automatic. I'd prefer a manual. It's not that I'm pressing the fake pedal and not getting a clutch. It's like yesterday I actually took this car for a proper drive, and in the corners it was pretty good actually, but when you need power, the automatic gearbox, it's not sports auto, I put it in sports mode, but it changes a bit slower than what I'd like. If I was to get an auto, it would definitely have to be a paddle shifter, unless it's a classic car. So next up, I'm going to head up to Traralgon. Hi everyone, so right now I'm at 90 Mile Beach. Now, I had to visit here because when I was about 10 years old I actually heard rumours about this place. And the thing is, in New Zealand, about 100 kilometres from where I live, there is another beach called 90 Mile Beach, which was famously shown on Top Gear, where they exposed that it wasn't actually 90 miles, it was 90 kilometres. So when I was about 10 years old, I had a friend from Australia, and he told me that there is a beach in Australia called 90 Mile Beach that actually is 90 miles long. And here I am. So I'm facing the Tasman Sea, pretty much South Pacific. Across there should be New Zealand, and I'll check on the maps later, but I might even be facing 90 Mile Beach in New Zealand. And yes, it is a very windy day today. Overcast, cloudy, which for me is good because it's about 22 degrees. If it was sunny, it would be a lot hotter, but it would also look a lot nicer. Now, this is going to be my first time going into Australian water. I heard it's a lot warmer than New Zealand water. Hi, so now it's the end of the journey. I decided to take a detour through the Transalpine Road, I believe it's called, and it's really foggy out here. Just a few minutes ago, I pulled over to turn around and there were a couple bikers here that were seemingly lost. They were weighing up whether they should continue up to Dargo, which is the nearest town, or head back to Melbourne like me, and, well, rather than risk it on these tight mountain roads full of fog, I decided that I'll just head back. I'm not actually sure if there's anything to look at in Dargo. All I know is that there's a hotel and a place to turn around. Now, I'll flip the camera around and show you just how foggy it is. So that's the way I came. The fog has actually eased up a little bit. I'll show you a photo later. That's where I was planning on heading. So because of all this fog, I just decided to turn around and head back to Melbourne. It's already 4:30 and it'll probably take, it says 8:06 p.m. I'll arrive back in Melbourne, so don't really want to be driving on some back roads in the dark in a country I don't know. But yeah. Well, give you one last look at the scenery here. Looks pretty nice. It reminds me of Dirt Rally 2.0 or Dirt 4, whichever one has Australia in it. A nice big sweeping hairpin over here. Too bad it's very foggy. Alright, so back to when I go.